Week 7 of Back to Viz Basics Flourish Edition. We're going to create a symbol map. I will be honest, I didn't love this challenge. I don't know. I just wasn't into it. It wasn't very exciting to me. The data's, I mean, it's fine. I got to learn how to make a projection map, and I'll show you a little HTML to spice up your pop-ups. But, yeah, I don't know. This will be real quick, so hang in there. Let's see what we got. We have data on the wonders of the world. So we've got the name of the wonder, the different type, the latitude and longitude on the map, link to the Wikipedia page, link to a picture, and the year it was built. So, I don't know. I mean, maybe you find this more fun than I did. Let me scoot over to the data. Ignore this text box for a moment. We're going to come back to it. This is going to be my HTML code. So we've got the name. You know, there's about 50 here. The different type. There are different types of wonders of the world. Latitude, longitude, all the data right here. So let's just grab it. Copy it. You can see some of these years we don't actually know. So, okay, that's fine. And you can tell I'm not that into this one, but we'll learn. We're going to learn. We're going to make the projection map. Okay. So I'm in Flourish. I'm going to create a projection map world with points. So remember, I'm going to click this. When you go into a projection map, this is where you end up in any of the maps in Flourish. You end up with multiple tabs in the data area. So here there's regions. So that's, you know, you want to add, I don't know, GDP by country. You would put your data in here, and that's going to map to the geometry, right? And this is how you do the mapping. And then same thing with points. We're going to do the mapping here. When we're going to add points, you don't really need to match the points anywhere because I'm going to add latitude and longitude, right? Same thing with the lines. If I go here, you can see I'm going to have to add some data here, but I'm not going to do that for this one, just to point out. So you have multiple tabs here. So for the points, let's just clear this data out. See, the problem is I only have 50 observations. And so if I copy my data here, I'll show you. If I copy my data or paste it in, so you can see, here's my data. It doesn't overwrite all of this data. So that's still all there. So when I make the map, it's going to look strange. So I'm just going to drop down, hit clear, get rid of all that and drop my stuff in. And I'll paste that in. And let's see what we got. So the name, yep, that's good. The label. Sure. Label by type, latitude, longitude. That's good. Let's color it by the type. So let's put that as B and size. We don't need to size it. And then for pop-ups, it's going to automatically include columns A, B, C, D, cause that's in the viz. So I'm going to add E to G here. Cause I'm going to use some of that. So let's go over to the data, and yeah, this is pretty close. We can clean this up a little bit, obviously. Let's go to our points layer. Let's make this a lot bigger. Let's make these a lot bigger. 7 seems good. Let's go to labels. I want to turn the labels off. I don't need all those. Let's turn those labels off. That's a little better. I don't like the opacity like that. I'm going to make that a little bit darker. That's good. I've got my legend here. That will work fine. Because it's sitting here bothering me, let's change the footer to Back to Viz Basics Week Number 7. And let's go and grab the URL here. And let's paste it over. There we go. And we're going to need a header. And let's just say 7 Wonders of the World. I admit, that's not a good title, but okay. So when we hover on our pop-ups, that's not great. That kind of looks terrible. It's just dropping in everything. So let's go to the pop-ups panel. We're going to customize this. And so now when I hover on it, it just gives me the default stuff. Now, I've gone back and forth on this. Because when I go back to auto, you know, maybe I want some of this, but not all of this. And it does annoy me a little bit that when I click to custom, that it just gives me the default stuff, right? So if you go over here into this window, there are these little question marks, right? It tells me how to format this pop-up header and this content header. So why does it tell me I need to do this again? I just don't understand that. So, okay, it's fine. I'm not a software developer. Just saying, Flourish folks, if you're listening, if you're watching, I'd rather have whatever the HTML code that creates this, I'd rather have this already populated in the custom panels so that I could just tweak it and move it around as opposed to having to figure it out by hand. So let's go back to my Excel file. I already have some code written here. Let's go back over. Let's drop it in here and let's see what we get. Ooh, that's kind of nice. Okay, but we do need a header here. So let's do the name. Let's go back and see what we got. Oh, that's nice. So it looks like I have a few things kind of messed up in my HTML code. So let's go in here and change this a little bit. So, okay. So first thing, the image is a little too big for that window. So I'm just going to change that. That fits in nicely. Year built, should have year built, and I need to put a little break there. Let's see if that helps. Because it's not called year built. Oh, I didn't add year built to my, I forgot it. It's in column H. We need to change this to H. Let's go back. Now we should have it fixed. Year built, learn more. Wonder if I can make those images just a little bigger. 150 by 150. Yeah, fits in nicely. I could even change this to a panel if I wanted. So now I'd have to go back and re-customize that. So let's actually go back, grab this panel and customize the panel content down here, paste in the same thing. So is this better or worse? I think I like the pop-up. I haven't really thought long and hard because I don't do a lot of this sort of interactive design, whether a panel is better or when a panel is better versus a pop-up. I think here I just want to be able to click. And actually, now that I'm looking at this, I don't love the Eckert 4. So let's see if I can use... Oh, definitely don't want that. Albert's just going to show me the USA. I guess I'm going to stick with the Eckert 2, but I don't love it. It's so stretchy. And you know what I'm not going to use? Oh, they don't even have a... I'm just looking through all these. They don't even have a Mercator in here? Good job, Flourish. Gold star. No Mercator in here. Love it. I don't know all these other ones. So, okay. The mole wide. You cartographers, let me know what a good projection is. I actually like this one. Kind of a little rounder, I think, there. So I've got my point map. Again, wasn't too excited about this one, but it's in there. It's kind of set up. You can click around. You can play around. It's even got the names of the countries in here, so that's kind of fun too. But as you can see, you can hover over each of my... Ooh, you know what? One more thing. I know I keep saying I'm going to go, but then I see one thing. I actually love the difference when I do a panel or do a pop-up. When I customize the styles, I like putting my little header in the block. I think it just looks a little better. Ooh, that's nice. That's so good. All right, I hope you enjoyed this one. Take a look. This one's pretty easy to do. Grab that projection map, drop your data in, play around with your pop-ups. Let me know how it goes. Subscribe to the channel, and I will see you next time for another edition of Back to Viz Basics Flourish Edition.